Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to be talking about what is the importance of light wheels. Nowadays all the performance motorcycles and the four-wheelers, I mean the cars, are running behind lighter wheels, and I'm going to be explaining you what is the importance of these lighter wheels and what are the advantages and how it's gonna work in favor of the cars or bikes performance. So let's get started with the video. Now if you like the looks of the wheels and try to buy it, so make sure you first check the weight of the wheels, because it's gonna have a drastic improvement or decrement in the performance of your automobile. Now the most important things which are gonna play part in this regard is the sprung weight, the unsprung weight, and the rotational mass. I'm going to be explaining you all these terminologies and telling you how it will work on the performance of your bike or your car. Now let's get started with all the three major topics. The number one is the sprung weight or the mass. Sprung weight is the total weight of the car, I mean all the parts of the car that is supporting by the car's suspension. Some of them are like the engine, the exhaust, bodywork, interior parts, your chassis, everything comes under the sprung weight. All this weight is trying to push your car downwards. Now this will have a major effect whenever you go on a bump, because the wheels tends to move more when the sprung weight is more. So you don't wanna be adding more weight on your car, because of which the spring will move downwards more and the sprung weight will also increase. The unsprung weight or the mass is the total weight that are not supported by the car's suspension. Like we are talking about the parts which are like the absorbers, springs, suspension links, axles, etc., and also the braking system, of course. This will have a drastic improvement in your handling of your car or your bike, because unsprung weight is the terminology which will improve your handling by directly or indirectly. The smaller the amount of unsprung weight, the more effectively the suspension will be able to do its stabilizing job on the uneven roads. So reducing the unsprung weight will result in an overall better handling car or a bike with a better driving feeling. Because the unsprung weight, like the travel of the suspension, is reducing, so whenever you go on a bump or a uneven road, even on the corners, the travel between the wheel and the body will be less. So this will make you feel that your car is very stable and it's not bouncing around whenever you go on an uneven road. And this steadiness or the stabilizing work, whatever the unsprung mass is trying to do, will make you confident on riding or driving your bike or car. This is the most important thing that you have to take care whenever you are searching for a lighter wheel to put on your car or a bike, and making it appealing car or a bike for you in terms of looks as well as performance as well. The third thing which is most important and the most taken care topic by every manufacturer nowadays is the rotational mass. Now whenever you see the modern alloys or the wheels, you will observe that the outer section of spokes are thin and the inner section of the wheel or the alloys are thicker. Now what does this mean is, if you see the outer section of the rims or the alloys or the wheels of a automobile, it is thinner, means the centrifugal force acting on the wheels is lesser. Now what is this centrifugal force? Now if you see, if you multiply the weight into the distance, will result the amount of force acting on the wheel. Force is equal to a mass into distance between the center and the outer edge of the wheel. So because the weight of the spoke in the outer section is less, the force acting on the wheel will reduce. If the weight of the outer section of the wheel is high, the centrifugal wheel force will increase, and this will drastically affect your performance in terms of acceleration and braking as well. Because when you are accelerating, you want the least amount of centrifugal force or the drag that will provide on your wheels, because all the horsepower will not reach to the ground. Because when the horsepower is producing in an engine, some of the horsepower will get lost when it is transferring from crankshaft to transmission, transmission to axles, axle to drive shafts, and drive shafts to the wheels, and from wheels to the ground. So all this process, the amount of horsepower lost is from around 15 to 20%, and you don't want to lose more horsepower due to the higher weight of the wheel in the outer edges. Reducing the weight around the edges will improve your acceleration, because when the force is very less to rotate the wheel, the acceleration will improve. Same it will work on the braking as well, because the larger the force acting on the wheel, the higher the distance that the car or a bike will take to stop. Because whenever you stop, the force acting on the wheels must be minimum, so that it can take as minimum distance as possible to stop from whatever the speed you are going to zero. The lightweight of the wheels also plays an important role in the handling as well, because if you have a lightweight wheels in your car, it is very easy to steer as well. You don't have to put lots of force or lots of energy if you want to steer the vehicle. And the same applies in the bikes as well. When the weight of the wheels are very less, the changing of the direction from right to left or vice versa is very easy. Because of the less weight of the wheels, there is a least amount of energy that is required to change the direction and also to take turns. Now, these are all the terminologies that are taken care whenever you manufacture or try to buy a aftermarket wheel or an OEM wheel that you have to take care. Now, all this engineering comes at a cost, because lighter weight wheels are very costly. Whenever you try to buy an aluminium or a magnesium or a carbon fiber wheel, they are very expensive. Compared to the normal alloy wheels, aluminium alloy wheels are forged. Nowadays, all the aluminium alloy wheels are forged, so it's going to increase the cost. So forged aluminium alloy wheels are going to cost you the least in these three categories. The next is the magnesium wheels, because the magnesium wheels are very tricky to manufacture, because even if you increase a slight in the amount of temperature while manufacturing it, the metal will catch fire. The third thing is the carbon fiber wheels. These are very hard to find and very expensive as well, because whenever you try to find a carbon fiber wheel, it has to be weaved and it has to be in a perfect shape. All the carbon fiber wheels are well over some amount of bikes as well. You can get a decent performing bike on the cost of a set of a carbon fiber wheels. So that's all in this video, guys. Make sure you subscribe to my channel if you like my information and like my video.